Hannon B70 is a free virtual drawbar organ with a rotary speaker that really takes you back to the 70s. A great sound and very useful presets, so stay tuned and we will show you how this sounds and works. First, let me ask you to subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you subscribe, we will keep you updated on all the great free software and tools we review. Hannon B70 of Lost in 70s is an emulator of the legendary Hammond B3 with a 122 Leslie speaker with two rotors. The creators at Lost in 70s really did a good job on this. It sounds great and it's easy to work with. So let's see how this plugin can be downloaded and installed. The downloads page of Lost in 70s has several free instruments on that page. We already did a review of the Keys of the 70s plugin, which you can find on our website. The Hannon B70 comes in 7 different formats, like Windows 64-bit VST3 and VST, but also an .exe file to install. Windows 32-bit VST3 and VST are also available, and for Mac there is a VST3 and Audio Units version available. Just pick the one you need and click on Download. We downloaded the VST3 version for Windows 64-bit. This is a zip file that only holds the DLL file. This DLL file needs to be copied to a specific place where all the VST3 plugins are stored. For Windows, that's a fixed folder you can find at /c/programfiles/common/files/VST3. All you have to do is copy the DLL to that folder and then you can start your DAW. The Hannon B70 plugin shows us 2 rows of 9 drawbars in the upper middle. The left 9 drawbars are the upper keyboard that's connected to MIDI channel 1, and the other 9 drawbars are the lower keyboard which listen to MIDI channel 2. So you can use 2 different tracks to control both sets of drawbars. If you want to use both sets on one keyboard, you can use the split button at the bottom right. The lower part of your keyboard will then play the second set of drawbars. If you want to move the split, you can use the split learn button to set another split point. At the left upper corner you see the vibrato section, where you can select what type of vibrato you want using the rotary knob. Most Hammond players do not use the vibrato a lot. Totally at the top right you see 4 buttons for the percussion. You can choose between the 3rd and 2nd harmonics, which is related to the 5th drawbar and the 4th drawbar. This percussion button gives you some extra push at the beginning of the note. You can choose to have a slow or fast decay of the percussion note, switch from normal to soft, and of course an on and off switch, like on the original Hammond organs. At the bottom part we see the Leslie speaker simulation at the left. Here you can switch your Leslie on and off, and switch between slow and fast, which can also be done by using the modulation wheel of your MIDI keyboard. You also see a slider that gives you control over the balance between the upper and lower part of the Leslie, which are 2 different rotary speakers. And the slider below that gives some extra overdrive to the sound. The slider in the middle is for adding a key click, like we also hear in the original Hammond organs. And the slider below that is the balance between the upper and lower keyboard when you use it in split mode. The last slider is the leakage level that gives you some extra sound leaking from the organ like in the old times. It's very subtle. The last three knobs are for the reverb, which I found sound a bit like the old spring reverbs, which lots of organs used as a reverb in the 70s. The creator also made some presets to start with. You can find 13 of them at the bottom of the plugin to get you started. Well, that's all I can say about this great organ plugin. Let's play some of the presets to hear what this 70s machine can do. I think this is one plugin you have to have in your collection. More information and the download link can be found on our website. The link is below this video. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep you updated on all the great and free software we review. Now play! Thank you.